Okay, before we start, let's get one thing out of the way. Shit, piss, fuck, cunt, cocksucker, motherfucker, tits. I mean, I know them, I just never get the order right, but now that that's out of the way, YouTube's not monetizing this, and anyone that lets YouTube's algorithm or monetization policy control what they say, how do you trust anything else they say after that, right? So, it's after 4:30 in the morning here. I can't sleep because I was an old man and took a nap yesterday now. But something's been bugging me. You know, it's that thing, that thing going around about DriveThru RPG. The statement they made about the OGL. If you're deep enough into things that you're in this video, then you've seen it around. They basically released a statement that could be implied to mean that anything that had Wizards of the Coast deauthorized, the 1.0A OGL, that everything released under that license would have been taken down from DriveThru RPG. That's not the only way to interpret the statement, but frankly, do any of these people deserve the benefit of the doubt? Is there any reason not to have the pessimistic interpretation, right? But yeah. I don't know. First of all, I just want to say, I'm a bad businessman. And I don't know how to deal with people. My management style is, oh, cross the fingers and hope shit works. I don't know how to deal with people. And I'm the most unconscientious worker you'll ever meet. And the evidence of this is all over my career. So the things I'm about to say, it's not a pitch of saying that me or someone like me should be in charge, because that's not the case. But, you know, but the reason I think Lamentations has carried on for 13 and a half years now, some better times, some worse, is I got a little bit of talent, a little bit of talent. I've got, you know, I've got apparently a unique point of view. I have a passion for the subject matter and in presenting things to people. And I guess I have a little bit of charisma enough to drag some people along with me on the journey. So that's what I have. And then I look at Wizards of the Coast and then DriveThru, and for this video I'm going to assume the pessimistic interpretation that all of the old OGL stuff was going to be taken down. I'm just making that assumption for this video. So I look at the people in charge and I wonder, how is it that the people that are in charge of the major institutions in the tabletop role-playing industry are actually in charge of the major institutions in the tabletop role-playing industry? How do these people get to be in charge of... Oh, God. It's distressing. Because they don't seem to give the first shit about the thing that is basically in their care. DriveThru RPG is not quite a monopoly, but effectively so. They have to be the absolute largest single RPG store in the world. And a lot of people depend on them for income, you know. Had the thing last summer about the hostile marketing. You want to look that up. But it should have been their job, if Wizards of the Coast was going to do this, to deauthorize the OGL, it should have been their duty and in their best interest to say no. Or at least say, you know, well, we're not taking any of this stuff down. I mean, think of how many hundreds, if not thousands of publishers were depending on them in getting their stuff to the public. And when Wizards was going to take a crap on their own promise, DriveThru was going to help them? How could that possibly have been a thing? I really would like to hear a clarification that that was never going to be the case, and that this recent statement was just basically just trying to calm people down in a way that, you know, you fall down and break your leg and the paramedic's like, okay, you're fine, you're not going to die. And you think, I could have died? You know, I'm hoping it's something like that, but it would be nice to get a clarification or something, because I know that they've got the DM's Guild that's attached to them, and that's got to be a big deal for them. But Wizards of the Coast is still one publisher. And the idea that DriveThru would stand up with the one publisher, with the one publisher, to shit on everyone else really means, if that's the case, that they're the enemy. I mean, Wizards of the Coast have made themselves the enemy, even though they've backed down from their current thing. But even the Wizards of the Coast, how was this decision made? Obviously, nobody in charge there gives a shit about the people they are supposed to serve with their products. I mean, DriveThru has, you know, customers, but then also the publisher clients. So they have, I don't know, saying it's a conflict might not be right, but they've got different priorities. You know, there could be tension in what's good for the customer versus what's good for the publisher. And if they make a decision either, you know, but just siding with one and to say fuck everyone else, it's like, how, who was responsible for that? I mean, if that's what happened, we collectively as the customers, because I buy stuff too, you know, we collectively as customers of this industry, never mind creators and publishers and part being part of the industry, I want to know who made that decision. Who made that call that if Wizards was going to pull the trigger, then they were going to execute for them? Because that's just fucking gross. And how do you get to a position in this industry where you can decide to just fuck people like that? Just on purpose, consciously decide, fuck everyone, we're siding with the big money. And how can you be trusted with any decisions going forward after that? Same thing with Wizards of the Coast. I mean, it's, I don't get it. I don't get it. The people who had originally wanted this new open game license obviously aren't gaming people. They don't understand or care, again, about the people they're trying to serve. And how does a person like that get into that position? Obviously, they're part of a larger corporation who, but I see, this is what breaks my brain. I mean, I have to serve the people that I'm hoping give me money for my products. Or even this YouTube thing. If I'm wanting to make money from this YouTube thing, you know, if not for monetization, then for, you know, a Patreon or something later, I still have to serve the people who would be interested in giving me money for that, or interested in watching the videos that create the advertising revenue. I still have to perform a service and serve the people. And whatever stupid decisions I make, if it people decide it doesn't serve them, they go. And you know, I have to take that into account, you know, my creative impulses and the mischief that I want to do versus the fact that I am a business and I have to serve the customers. In the end, you know, after whatever stupid shit I'm doing, the customer must be served with a product that they find interesting or useful or whatever the reason is you people buy stuff. And there's no illusion that I'm the only game in town. That even for like weird fantasy or horror fantasy, I hope we're doing something unique. But if we completely shit the bed, there's a dozen other people that may be close enough for government work, you know? And I know that. But Wizards of the Coast and DriveThru either don't know that or think they've got enough of the pie that they don't have to care about anyone else. And that's wrong. I mean, that's it's not like a morally wrong, but it's like that's factually wrong. And what makes it worse is if they shit the bed, and if they make the kind of decisions like the ones they've been making, never mind the backtracking, because when you backtrack, that's not what you wanted to do. So they're still going to want to move forward with some, like, fucking stupid shit that they're going to try to do to consolidate and get their money for their plans. That why at this point should we believe that those plans have anything to do with serving their customers? And I don't know. Sometimes it just makes me feel so naive. Like how can the world possibly work like this? How does this work? It's like it doesn't work. It doesn't work at all. Who is happy with how anybody is running anything these days? I guess I am an old man yelling at the clouds. But there seems to be no competence. That you fit a profile and so you can get installed in a position, regardless of whether you actually fit that position. And I think people in charge of a gaming company should, at the very least, understand the gamers, be one of the customers at some point before assuming their position. And understand how they think and know, you know what? We're going to make lots and lots of money because we're going to do something that the people want. Shouldn't that be how it works? And so, you know, I don't know. It's just so depressing. It's just because, and the reason I care is because I believe if Wizards of the Coast and Dungeons & Dragons shits the bed, as, you know, yes, I mean, Lamentations, like a lot of other companies, has had a phenomenal January. And, you know, I've been doing some things with the channel that may have attracted attention, but a good amount of that is probably from Wizards of the Coast shitting the bed. And people looking for alternatives. I've been hearing other companies have done really well as, you know, also. But that's going to be a small, small minority, I think. Enough to fuel smaller companies. But if Wizards of the Coast really shits the bed, and the Dungeons and Dragons customer and fan base flees, I think most of those people just go on to do something else with their lives. They don't take up Lamentations of the Flame Princess or Pathfinder or Call of Cthulhu or whatever the hell is out there. I mean, yes, again, we'll all get a bump. Maybe, you know, a great bump for our businesses, but I think a significant portion of the role-playing customer base and fan base simply disappears and, you know, and they're done. And the same thing with DriveThru. If they had done something so monumentally awful, like cancel and deactivate every single thing on their site that had used the Open Game License 1.0A. If that had gone through, if this all hadn't been leaked, and that went through and they did that, people would be rebelling against them. The same as people rebelled against Wizards of the Coast. And again, if people lost faith and permanently said, screw you, DriveThru, no more, where'd people go? Yeah, you got things like, you know, Big Geek Emporium always gets named, but that's still a very small operation. And I don't think that, you know, someone appears to take up the space. I think a lot of the print-on-demand business, a lot of the PDF sales, just go away. Because the one thing about DriveThru right now is they have created a lot of convenience for customers and a lot of value for the publishers, even with the 30 to 35% cut they take. That's normal. The 50% DMs guild, that's you just getting fucked if you're using that. But, you know, they've created a lot of value by creating this marketplace where everybody is. That's why they're important. That's why, you know, with the stuff last year, when I got upset with them, you know, with the hostile marketing thing, you know, I surely didn't want to lose them, but they have to act like they are the stewards of so much material. And if they don't want to screw up their being the one-stop shop for a lot of role players, they can't act like they're over everybody. They can't do it. Same thing with Wizards of the Coast. They can't act like they're above their customers, they're controlling their customers, that their customers are just going to buy any damn thing, that no matter what they do. You know, and that's something I got to worry about every day. You know, is this thing that I'm working on, is this next thing, is this the straw that breaks the camel's back and the people finally say to hell with this shit and I'm done? And it seems the bigger the company you are, that you no longer think about that. And you really should. And, yeah. I don't know. I don't know what to do. I mean, calling for heads to roll. Oh, these people need to be fired, and whoever was going to do this at DriveThru needs to go. It's like, yeah, whatever. You know, if they're just going to be replaced by someone else that has this detached business thinking that's not, that's more about servicing the business and not serving the customer, I don't know that it matters what the name is in the office. You know, is it going to be new boss, same as the old, trying the new shit to move the numbers in a certain way regardless? It's... It's the shitty way for the market to operate. You know, it needs to be for mutual benefit. You know, the company, you know, I wish, you know, I'm not saying, you know, oh, bad rich people, because if someone gets rich providing a product or a service that enough people really want, that it makes them rich, good on you. But this sort of, I don't know, Nah, I'm not going to go into theory at freaking 5 in the morning that I barely even have a grasp on when I'm fully rested, but, yeah. I don't know. I didn't want this channel to become a vlog. You know, I'm hoping just to do, you know, my silly shit, and then once I get more technical expertise, go for the disgusting and gory stuff, because you can't, you know, to do funny stuff, you just need a decent premise or a good script, and just be willing to make a fool of yourself. Comedy. To do the serious stuff, you need some technical expertise, and I ain't there yet. So, yeah, I just, thought I'd ramble. Didn't know I'd ramble quite this long, but I just wanted to get these thoughts out because somehow, some way, the YouTube channel is now the way that my thoughts go out into the world more than any other. So hopefully not too much of this in the future. You know, I get to announce sales and do more entertaining stuff, but yeah. But I'm challenging all you YouTubers out there. Don't change how you talk. Or if you're going to change how you talk, do it to cause trouble. The 7 dirty words. I dare everyone to start their next video with the 7 dirty words and tell the YouTube monetization algorithm that it can go fuck itself if it's going to restrict the actual content. Because I refuse to believe that, like, the freaking mobile, you know, the mobile game that it's got the, oh, the damsel, you know, give a shit that someone says poop in their, anyway. Yeah. I guess that's another rant, but I'll leave this one here. Well, I hope if this was boring that it bored you enough to fall asleep, the kind of sleep that I wish I could be having right now. And I'll just leave it there and start uploading this, so.